Hey guys, thank you for checking out this video. This time I will give you an overview of the attach process, which is one of key processes in semiconductor packaging. I'm Lito Galera, and let's start learning. You just saw the die attach process in action. The process involves multiple machine subassemblies that are in motion, wherein timing of each movement is very important for the process to work properly. Let me discuss the die attach process in more detail. The work holder does the handling of lead frames or substrate from input to output stage. The input loader takes stacks of lead frame or substrate and pins them to the indexer. The indexer moves the lead frame or substrates from input to output in sync with the dispenser and pick and place assembly. The epoxy dispenser is mounted along and over the indexer. The epoxy is dispensed on every program position of the die attach pad or DAP. For sub-solder die attach, the epoxy dispenser is replaced by a solder wire feed station. While for eutectic die attach process, there is no epoxy dispenser or solder wire station. The output handler collects the completed lead frame or substrate to a carrier called magazine. The wafer handler, as the name implies, handles the sewn wafer that is mounted on a tape. The tape is expanded once loaded onto the wafer handler to have larger spacing between dies. Without tape expansion, the die, during pickup, will hit or bump the adjacent dies, and that will cause die damage or chipping. The pick-and-place system includes a bond arm and ejector subassemblies. The bond arm picks up the die from the wafer and mounts it onto the lead frame or substrate. Depending on manufacturer, some machines have straight or linear bond arm, and while others have swivel arm. The ejector assembly is mounted in the middle and below the wafer handler. A special ejector needle made of steel or tungsten carbide is used to eject or push up the die from the mounting tape. In some cases, particularly for thin die application, plastic needles are used. It is important that only the good dies are processed and the bad dies are left on the tape. The common method for screening the good and the bad dies is using a pattern recognition system, or PRS. The PRS, if programmed properly, will recognize the unique pattern of a good die and also can recognize the ink dot. As each die is scanned, the machine will skip picking up the ink dies and pick up only the good dies. The attach process has certain specifications that are important and critical to device performance. Epoxy coverage is expected to be 100% under the die, and with visible epoxy fillet of at least 90% on each side of the die. If these requirements are not met, the device can be rejected due to quality concern. It is quite common to hear BLT when discussing the attach process. BLT stands for bond line thickness. This is the thickness of adhesive epoxy under the die. Typical requirement is at least 25 microns before epoxy curing. To meet epoxy coverage and BLT requirements, it is important to dispense the correct amount and shape of epoxy, and also to control bond height. Correct epoxy volume can be achieved by using dispensing nozzles that are designed for specific die sizes, and by optimizing the dispensing process parameters. Another die attach requirement is a die placement and die orientation. The die placement and orientation is driven by wire bonding layout and is specified in the build diagram. Typically, the die is placed on the center of the die attach pad, but in some cases, it can be on the left or right side of the pad and can also be rotated at a certain angle to accommodate wire bonding requirements. That completes the die attach process overview in this video. I will discuss in the next slide some details about process setup. If you want to continue learning about the die attach process, then just stay on. As I mentioned earlier, it is important to use the right dispensing nozzle to achieve proper epoxy coverage. Because die comes in different sizes, nozzles of different sizes and designs must also be available. This slide shows the mix and match of different die sizes and nozzle design. Note that some machines have epoxy writing dispensing capability. Instead of using dispensing nozzles, it uses a single needle to dispense epoxy. The dispensing needle is mounted on a programmable motorized XY assembly that writes according to the program dispensing pattern. Let's now talk about die ejector setup. Again, die comes in different sizes. A small die requires a single needle, but a larger die must use two or more needles and must be configured according to die shape. Ejector setup is critical to make sure that the die is picked up properly without any damage and misrotation. A damaged die, like chipped or cracked, must be rejected as this poses a significant reliability risk. Ejector needle pushes the die up from the mounting tape at a height of approximately 1 to 1.5 times die thickness. If the die is not clear at the proper height during pickup, it is likely to hit the adjacent die once the bond arm moves to the bond position. Another thing to consider is the needle tip radius. A piercing needle has a small tip radius. It pierces through the tape and may cause microcrack on die backside during pickup as the pickup tool is pressing on the die and against the needle. This is especially true for large thin die. For wafers that are mounted using standard tacky tape, it is common to use piercing needles, but whenever possible, it is recommended to use needle with larger tip radius. Thin wafers are typically mounted on UV tape, which has zero adhesion once exposed before the attach process. This allows use of non-piercing needles for UV tape mounted wafers. Just to recap the attach process specifications. Epoxy coverage must be 100% with visible epoxy up more than 90% on each side of the die. Epoxy fillet height must be controlled at less than 75% of die thickness to avoid epoxy contamination on die surface. Epoxy on die manifestation is considered a reject. Epoxy voids under the die must be zero. Voids can lead to thermomechanical stress that can damage the die. Bond line thickness needs to be at least 25 microns with wet epoxy. But note that too high BLT might cause unnecessary die rotation issue. Die shear strength is done after epoxy cure, which is a test of die adhesion to epoxy, and also the epoxy adhesion to lead frame or substrate. A good die shear result will have sheared die as break mode. You should refer to mill standard specs for minimum shear force requirement. Feel free to drop a comment, question, or email. To support this channel, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Thank you for watching.